Philadelphia 76ers. I'm going to open this up in a new tab just to see a full view of it. Okay. Well, I always kind of dislike the logos that incorporate a basketball, or the logos that are just within a circle. I've always kind of disliked those ones. But I think that the Sixers manage it in a way that it looks very clean and very like crisp, if that makes any sense. So Sixers, I'm gonna have to give that a B. Then we move on to the Washington Wizards. Now again, they're incorporating a basketball within a circular logo. However, they have a couple touches that I like. Obviously, they have the Washington Monument here in the center representing they're in our nation's capital, so it's a landmark there. And then the big star here above the Washington Monument, the two stars here on the side, and they have the red, the white, and the blue, the stripes. I don't like it as much as the Philadelphia one, but I think it's on the same tier, so I'm going to put it into B tier. Let's go to Atlanta Hawks. The Atlanta Hawks. Again, this is another circle logo, which seems to be a theme with a lot of NBA teams for some reason. I do like how they have the hawk within the center, though, and how it's in this, like, negative space, almost. Like, you have the hawk here, and then this white backdrop that it's in. But other than that, I don't know, it's just red and white. There's not a lot going on, and there aren't, like, little touches like the Washington logo. I'll also put it there into B. That might get moved around. Okay, let's move to the Cleveland Cavaliers. I'm not really a big fan of the shield, if I'm being honest. I think that's kind of, I don't know, just putting a logo onto a shield or something like that. It's, to me, I'm not a huge fan of it. I don't know. I'd rather just see the logo stand alone. However, here I do like the C, and then you have the sword going through it, because the Cavalier, you know, was a military thing. Also, is this even the logo they use on their jerseys? I don't think it is, don't they? Hold on, let me check. I feel like they don't use this logo. Yeah, they usually just use the big C. Although this season they aren't using it at all. They're just using jerseys as a Cleveland or Cavs. But usually they just use the big C. Yeah. I don't know. I like the sword, and I like the design of the C. The black shield, I could take it or leave it. I'm gonna put it, into B. I'm gonna drop these three into C. That's what I'll do. Detroit Pistons. I don't really need to do too much with this. Just a basketball. You have red, white, and blue, and then the word mark in the middle. I think that's a really boring logo. I'm gonna put it into D tier. The first D. actually. Let me do this. Favorite sport is hockey, and off the top of my head, I can't think of a single team that has a hockey stick or a hockey puck in their logo. I guess the Sharks have a hockey stick in their logo, but, you know, a puck, I don't think so. However, you have, this is like the peak of a mountain. This is like the snowy peak of the mountain. And then this is, you know, implying this negative space down here is the base of the mountain. And then you have these pickaxes here, you know, representing the prospectors going up into the mountains. I think that is an interesting take on the circle logo. And they worked in some iconography that is pertinent to the city. I'm going to put this at the top of C tier. The Memphis Grizzlies. The Memphis Grizzlies. I preferred them when they were the Vancouver Grizzlies, personally. But, I mean, what do we have here? We have a bear, you know, two-tone blues here. And then the yellow eyes. I do think that the grizzly bear could perhaps be a little more scary looking, a little more intimidating looking, especially as a sports team. You want to, you know, strike fear into the hearts of your opponents, but, you know, it's not a circle logo, which is good, and it, you know, it, I think it looks nice, it's clean, and it's one of those things that you look at it from a distance and you immediately know, okay, that's a grizzly bear. Saying some of these logos, like if you didn't know who the Indiana Pacers were and you saw this P with the basketball in it, would you know that's the Pacers? If you saw just the Mavericks horse and you didn't know who the Mavericks were, would you know that's a Maverick? Probably not, but you see this and you know that's a grizzly bear. So I'm gonna put that into A tier. The Minnesota Timberwolves. Another circle logo that I don't have a problem with. I like, you know, obviously you have the wolf here howling. I think that's a nice look. And you see it's like coming out from the bottom left of the circle because this little inner ring here gets cut off. So it creates an illusion of depth within the logo. You know, this is obviously in the foreground. And then you have another basketball behind it. But they're using the basketball as a representation of the night sky. And, you know, you have this little green patch here, which is supposed to be a star or something like that. So, just looking at this, you can tell that it's a timberwolf howling in the night, you know, probably towards the full moon. And you see the logo, and subconsciously, even if you're not aware of it, your brain is putting together that little story bit right there. And connecting that with the logo, so I think that's really well done. I'm going to take the Minnesota Timberwolves and put them into A tier. The San Antonio Spurs. Spurs. This is just the word mark bit. I don't think that they wear this full word mark on their jerseys. I think they mainly use this bit here, the actual spur, as their logo. I think it's alright. You see that and you immediately know what it is. That's a spur. I think they've been rocking the same logo for like a decade now, since they won all those titles, but if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It's not my favorite in the league, but it's good. I don't have any issues with it. I'm going to put that into B tier, ahead of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Alright, now we come to the Utah Jazz. If you watched my NHL logo video, you will know that I absolutely hate wordmark logos. I hate wordmark logos. Here you just have the Jazz, and then even if you just want to take this bit, the music note, which makes, you know, using a basketball and the tail of the letter J as a music note, I'm not a huge fan of that. I'm not a big fan as branding being in Utah in general. That's never made sense to me. Same with the Grizzlies being in Memphis. If anything, it should be the Utah Grizzlies, because I believe there are Grizzly Bears in Utah. Should be the New Orleans Jazz, and then the Memphis, I don't know, Ducks or something like that, because they have the Duck Pond up in Memphis, that famous Duck Hotel. But I digress. Not a big fan of the Utah Jazz logo. Probably put it into D tier. I need a quick sip of my beverage here. Add some, whatever the cotton candy flavor is of Bang Energy. That's what I'm drinking. Now we come to my least favorite logo in the entire NBA. The Clippers logo. I'm mainly just focusing on this bit, but just the L, the A, and the C. It's just, it's really uninspired. I think I hate this one worse than the Pistons logo, because at least the Pistons used a colorful basketball. Obviously, they're using the team colors here for the lettering, but it's just a white, minimalistic basketball design. You have the four lines and the little half circles there, and the way that this is designed, it almost is like an early 2000s, like, logo. I don't know if I'm, like, misremembering, but I feel like in the early 2000s, you saw a lot of things like this, with using, like, letters to make images and things, and it's just really dated, in my opinion. And I think I've stated before, I wish that the Clippers would use a boat or something like that for their design or for their logo, but this is just, it's my least favorite logo in the entire league, and it's at the bottom of F tier for me. Now we move to the Phoenix Suns. Again, on the shield, I dislike it personally, but I think more often than not, I think they just use the basketball sun as their logo. This is one way of incorporating a basketball into a design, which I don't hate. Obviously, they're using the basketball to indicate the sun, and then these are, you know, the solar flares or whatever they're called that comes off of the sun, you know, as it burns and turns and does its thing. And then you also have these movement lines, these speed lines indicating that the basketball sun is, you know, flying off out of frame, like somebody passed it or shooting it or something like that, almost like a shooting star. I think it works. It's not as bad as some of the other basketball logos. I think I would put it, there, between Denver and the Wizards. And you notice there's gonna be a lot of things in C tier, but that's just because I think most things are just about average. They're not exceptional, they're not terrible, they're just okay. Now we move to the Portland Trail Blazers. People might think I'm biased because I'm a fan of the Portland Trail Blazers, but in my opinion, they have one of the best logos in the NBA. I just think it's a really unique design, the pinwheel design, which, if people don't know, this is supposed to indicate 10 players on the basketball court playing. There's one line for each team, or excuse me, 5 lines for each team, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which represents the 5 players on each team in a game of basketball, and then they're kind of circling around and coming into the middle like a player moving around the basketball court, with the hole in the center being the center of the basketball court. So that's the design philosophy behind this logo. I only know that because, you know, I'm a fan, so I'm intimately familiar with the logo and the design principles around it and the team lore and all of that. But again, I think it's a logo unlike anything that any other team in any other sport has. And because of that, I think it is one of the best in the NBA. I'm going to put it, there at the top. Again, you might think I'm biased. I might be biased. I don't know, but that's just my opinion. Now I move to the Sacramento Kings. This is an interesting logo to me. You have the bottom half of a basketball here, obviously. And I'm not 100% certain, but I think that these lines are also supposed to be an homage to the rivers and such that are around the Sacramento area. And I think this top bit is supposed to be the mountains around that area. Again, I'm not sure, but Northern California, you have some mountain ranges up there, and I think around the Sacramento area that those are supposed to represent. Then it says Sacramento Kings. One thing I do really like about this logo, and one thing I like about the Kings in general, is that they use the color purple. Pink and purple are two of my favorite colors, and I feel like they are underrepresented colors across most sports leagues, so they immediately kind of get a bump up in my mind for using those colors. But again, you have a lot of the design is based around the word mark, which I'm not a huge fan of. And then I want them to do a change. I think it's a little, they've had this logo for a while, I think. I don't know, I'll put it in B tier. No, I'm gonna put it below the Suns. I'll put it there in C tier. The New York Knicks. Now I like the Knicks, but there's something about this logo I really dislike. I think it's because you have this like 3D effect on the Knicks lettering, and it kind of reminds me of like word art in Microsoft Word that people would use in like the early 2000s, if you're old enough to remember that. I remember like in middle school, whenever we'd have to type up a paper, like the cool thing to do was to go into like word art and make just a really obnoxious looking title using Microsoft Word, and you would use effects like this 3D effect on the text or things like that. And that's kind of always what this has reminded me of. It looks very early 2000s in my opinion. Especially because that 3D effect is not also applied to the New York at the top or to the basketball. And then there's this kind of like weird triangle that everything is just sitting on top of. But the triangle is also not 3D, so I don't know. I do like the Knicks, but I've never really been a fan of this logo. It's kind of lame in my opinion. I'll probably put it in D tier. I'll put it like the top of D tier though. Okay, now we have the New Orleans Pelicans. New Orleans Pelicans, Pelicans, Pelicans. I really like this logo, actually. I like the design of the Pelican here. Even though I don't like that New Orleans is still the Pelicans, I'd prefer for them to be the Jazz or maybe just something more New Orleans related in general, I think would be a better look for the team, but I digress. I like the design of the Pelican. I like the color scheme. This gold color with this like dark navy blue and this red, I think is a really cool color scheme. I think the Pelican itself looks intimidating. And then using the basketball kind of as the body of the Pelican, I think is a good use of the basketball iconography. The lettering here in New Orleans, even though I don't believe this is on the logo the players wear, you know, it has a very sort of, I'm not sure what the exact term is, but like that French Gothic style lettering with the little ornamentation, you know, all around it. And on the serifs, you have the interesting ornamentation. And then you have the fleur-de-lis up here at the top, you know, because because New Orleans and Louisiana in general has a lot of French influence there, especially with the Creole culture and all of that. And then you have this nice little ornamentation in gold sitting at the top. I think it is a really slick logo. I like it quite a bit. I would put it probably here up in A or S. Or A. I'm going to put it here below the Timberwolves and the Grizzlies. Actually, I want to put it ahead of the Grizzlies and Timberwolves. I'm actually going to rearrange it like that. There we go. Now we come to the Charlotte Hornets. I really, really like the Charlotte Hornets logo. I've always been a fan of the Hornets logo in general. I love their color scheme. That tealish blue color, the dark purple, and the white. I think that is a slick color scheme. One of the best color schemes in the entire NBA. And I love the way they incorporate the Hornet into the logo here. You know, you have the big bug eyes, the antenna, and the wings. And then the body of the Hornet houses the word mark for the team. And even the lettering is a little sharp and pointed, kind of like the stinger on the Hornet. I love this logo. I think it's sick. I'm putting it up here between the Blazers and the Bucks. Now I move on to the Houston Rockets. I'm mainly going to be paying attention to the big R here in the center. At first glance, it's kind of boring, and I do kind of agree that it is boring, but there is some interesting stuff going on with this logo that a lot of people might not notice. Now, obviously, this circle here around the base of the R, that's like the launch pad that a rocket is blasting off from, right? And then this R here, this is the, I don't know what it's called, but if you've ever watched a rocket launch, you know that support structure that the rocket is held in place by. That's what this R is supposed to represent. And then this line here that makes up, you know, the backside of the R, that is the rocket itself, which is preparing for liftoff. And you can tell that, you know, it comes up to a point here, which is like the nose of the rocket ship. So actually, I think it's a really nice way to incorporate the rocket iconography into a simple letter R. And again, I like that it isn't on a circle, it isn't on a shield, and it fits in the theme of the team in a really nice, sleek, ornamental way that I think looks awesome. I'm going to put this into A, just below the New Orleans Pelicans. And I said, a lot of people don't notice those little touches on the logo, but once you see them, you can't miss them. Miami Heat. This is an interesting one to me because I both love it and hate it. Obviously, you have the basketball, which is also a fireball. You can see it like coming into a ball of fire, and then you have the orange, you know, licks of the flame coming off the back there. And it's going through, you know, the basketball hoop here represented by this yellow circle, or this white circle, excuse me. It kind of reminds me of NBA Jam a little bit, this logo. And again, kind of like the Phoenix Suns, I think this is a really cool way to incorporate the basketball logo, where you can still tell that it's a basketball, but it's standing in for something else. It's not just a basketball. However, I do like their use here better than Phoenix's, especially with going through the hoop like this. And I'd probably put that. I'm gonna put this probably at the top of B tier. Now we come to this logo, the Bulls logo. It's really simple, but it's so classic and like so perfect. I feel like you don't need to mess with it. Like, you see this logo and you think everything you need to think just looking at it. You think Michael Jordan, you think GOAT, you think six titles, you think, like, you see that logo and you just think Chicago. You know what I'm saying? I love the design of the Bulls. tips of his horns, like obviously he's getting ready to fight his opponents, or he's just defeated his opponents. You have some of the really nice little lines and details here on the face where the bull looks angry. You know, his forehead is shriveled up. He's getting ready to charge his opponent. His ears are pulled back. All this stuff. I think it's an amazing logo. For me, this goes in S tier. I'll probably put it right there, S tier. The Brooklyn Nets. This is just a really boring logo to me. It's just the letter B within a basketball, and then the Nets on a black shield. It's just, I don't like it. I feel like I don't have to talk about it that much. Although I hate it less than the Clippers logo. That's just personal preference, so I'm going to put it between the Pistons and the Clippers. Actually, I think I like it better than the Pistons logo, just because it's the black and white, and it looks kind of clean, and yeah, I'll put it there at the top of F tier. Now we come to the Oklahoma City Thunder. I'm only mainly going to be paying attention to this bit here, which is the shield. I understand that thunder is a difficult concept to visualize because it's a sound, right? Lightning, much easier to visualize. You can have a lightning bolt, you can, you know, things like that, but thunder, hard, so I get it. But this is just kind of really lame to me. The OKC, and then you have a basketball, and then just a little bit of blue and yellow, and it's just, what is that? It's just not any good. I'm gonna put it in F. Actually, I'm gonna put that at the top of F. It's just not very good. Okay. The Golden State Warriors. As much as I dislike the Warriors, this is a clean logo. This is... It is a circle logo. I understand that, so maybe a little bit hypocritical of me, but I love the way they have the bridge iconography in here. It just looks nice. You see this and you're immediately like, oh yeah, San Francisco. And I love the use of the blue and the yellow. Then you have this yellow outline here, and it kind of provides a little bit of like perspective because there's a thicker blue line here at the bottom that compared to the top, so it kind of looks like it's, you know, larger at the bottom compared to the top. There's a little bit of perspective shift there. I probably am going to put the Warriors there. I want to put it there, just beneath the Nuggets. Okay, the Boston Celtics, a classic team with a classic logo. I mean, come on, right? That's, you have the leprechaun giving you a little wink, twirling the ball on his finger. He has the shamrocks all over his vest and bow tie there. He has his little cane. And that's one of the best logos in all of sports, right? I mean, even ignoring the circle, it's just, that's classic, that's iconic. And I love that it's persisted so long, and it's still... classic. I had to put that at the top of S. Now, I don't want to seem biased, but I'm just, this Lakers logo, like, I get it. You can't really change it. And also, what would you even change it to at this point? But it's literally just a basketball with the word Lakers on it. And then you have some, you know, speed marks, movement marks. So it looks like the Lakers is flying across the basketball. I don't know. I had to put that in D tier. It's just, there's not much going on there. And then finally, the Orlando Magic. I'm mainly going to be paying attention to this bit here. They're using the basketball as like a shooting star, which I think works pretty well. Or like a meteor or an asteroid, and you have the little stars here, you have the tail of it, up or something on the bottom as it enters the atmosphere. I think that's a nice little touch. Is it really magical, though? I don't know. Does this really evoke magic in my mind? Perhaps not, but it is. I think that the Magic are definitely due for an update to their logo, but definitely not one of the worst in the league. I'm probably putting that here, just ahead of the Mavericks. Alright, and that is that. So we now have my ranking of the NBA logos from best to worst. We have the Boston Celtics, the Portland Trailblazers, the Charlotte Hornets, the Chicago Bulls, the Milwaukee Bucks, the New Orleans Pelicans, the Houston Rockets, the Minnesota Timberwolves, the Memphis Grizzlies, the Miami Heat, the San Antonio Spurs, the Cleveland Cavaliers, the Denver Nuggets, the Golden State Warriors, the Phoenix Suns, the Sacramento Kings, the Washington Wizards, the Indiana Pacers, the Atlanta Hawks, the Orlando Magic, the Dallas Mavericks, the New York Knicks, the Philadelphia 76ers, the Toronto Raptors, the Utah Jazz, the Los Angeles Lakers, the Oklahoma City Thunder, the Brooklyn Nets, the Detroit Pistons, and the Los Angeles Clippers. I would love to hear any feedback on this video. I'm sure I'll definitely get some criticism for this, especially with putting the Lakers into D tier, but I mean, hey, you guys know my criteria. It's just my personal opinion, what I like to see in a logo. I'd love to hear what you agree with or disagree with. And if you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up. I appreciate that very much. And subscribe to the channel for more content just like this. Until next time, bye-bye.